Oh, Nicki. Finally getting to some Nicki Minaj. The theme of November and no hints and no telling what I'm going to do. For those of you who are possibly disappointed, I'm kind of interested in why, because from what I've gathered during this journey through hip hop over the last, I don't know, 16 months or something like that, Nicki's a pretty big deal. But what's interesting about her is it seems like her big dealness is somewhat disputed. Like, there are people who say she's a very iconic part of the hip hop culture. Other people say no, she's not. I don't know really where she lands when it comes to all that stuff. But here we are. Now, in terms of Pink Print versus Pink Friday, I know that Pink Friday was, I guess, her debut. I've heard lots of arguments both ways about, okay, which one should I do first? Pink Friday, obviously the debut. I've heard people say Pink Print was kind of the better album. I'm doing Pink Print because I think with Nicki, I want to get a taste of her maybe at her best. I don't know if this is necessarily her best one, but a lot of people talk about it. I've heard a lot of people say, yeah, this is probably her better project out of what she's done. If I enjoy it, then I go back. I'll probably check out Pink Friday at some point. But that's the reasoning behind Pink Print instead of Pink Friday. I looked and she's got a decent amount of music out there. I don't expect to go through her entire discography. But what I'm interested in going into this album is, okay, what is her rapping style? How good is she actually? Because I've heard all kinds of comments about her, right? And so it's fun for me to come in pretty neutral on her. I mean, I think I've heard her in a couple features. I loved her feature in Monster. That was a great feature. And there was another one she was on. I can't remember at the time, but I remember enjoying it quite a bit. And so the little tidbits that I've heard from her, I've enjoyed. So here in the album, I'm curious, okay, what's her vocal style like, her flow like, all this, what's the production gonna be like? I'm very curious. And I feel pretty neutral coming into this album, so I'm hopeful that I can walk away with just the impression of the album. That's one nice thing in that since her, I don't know what you would call it, her space in hip hop seems to be so disputed kind of across the board. It seems like that she's got big fans. It seems like she's got people that really aren't into her at all and try and downplay what she's doing. You got people in the middle who just enjoy it. So I don't really have any real sway in any direction, which is nice. I do understand that the fans, the hardcore fans, are called Barbs, which I love. I think that's a fantastic name because I immediately get this idea of Barbie, which kind of goes with the whole aesthetic that Nicki has, but I also think of barbed wire. So I just get this idea of, yeah, we're pretty, but we'll tear you up too. So that's kind of a cool idea for a fan base, a pretty fan base that will tear you apart if you fuck up. So anybody, maybe, I don't know, maybe you're watching this channel, seeing me for the first time because I'm doing this album. If you don't know, I just come in and I listen for the first time. Also, I wanted to do this album because I had so much fun last week with Thriller, and it was nice to just kick back and have fun. I don't have any expectation without this album in terms of like serious soul searching, gut wrenching, heartbreaking lyrics. I kind of expect some crazy shit and having fun with it. So I'll probably crack some jokes and things like that. If I'm doing that, it's me having fun and just enjoying what's being said. Also, this is the standard version of Pink Print. There's like all kinds of different versions, deluxe versions on. So there's some of them, one of them's like 1.5 hours long. This one's 66 minutes, the standard version. So I'm just doing that. I poked around at some of the track listing and it looks like there's just a couple extra songs that were featured or remixes or whatever. Okay. There's all the talking. First time listening to Nicki Minaj, her music, her album. First track is called All Things Go off of the Pink Print. Let's drop in. This album is almost 10 years old. Came out in 2014. It's sneaking up on 10 years old. That's right. That's right. I love saying shit like that. I love as I get older, I can drag everyone down with me. Produced by Alan Ritter, Vinylz, and Boy Wonder. Boy Wonder, I remember. I'm still not good at remembering who produced for what, though. Terrible. Just terrible. Anyway, all right, here we go. Track one, All Things Go, Nicki Minaj. Let's check it out.
Yo, I had to reinvent. I put the V in vent. I put the heat in vents. Man, I've been competing since. I look beyond what people saying and I see intent. Then I just sit back and decipher what they really meant. Cherish these nights. Cherish these people. Life is a movie, but there'll never be a sequel.
Good line.
And I'm good with that. As long as I'm peaceful. As long as 7 years from now I'm taking my daughter to preschool.
Good line.
Cherish these days. Man, do they go quick. Just yesterday, I swear it was 06. 10 years ago, that's when you proposed. I look down. Yes, I suppose.
Interesting.
I feel 1 minute, yeah, we got it, then it's gone.
Nice drop in. Nice vocals. This part's pretty catchy right here. One thing I really enjoy about this already is how, you know, I came in not expecting anything serious. And this is a pretty serious song, which is great because it puts me right in front of a preconceived notion, right? A misconception that I had about Nicki. And it's interesting because where did I get those ideas? Just from out there, the internet, the media spaces, right? Nicki's this and Nicki is that and all this other stuff. And so I had this idea. And there's, you know, part of it too is her aesthetic. She has a very vibrant aesthetic. So those things coupled with what I've heard about her, and I think, oh, okay, like she's probably a pretty good rapper from what people say, but maybe it's just, maybe the content itself isn't taken seriously. That's why people try and put her down. This is a great song. This is a great song. And it's cool because already these misconceptions about Nicki are being shattered, which I fucking love it when that happens. I love when I can sit down with somebody's art and enjoy it for what it is and just watch these ideas that were never mine to begin with go away. I really like this opening portion here. Cherish these people. Life is a movie. There'll never be a sequel. Great fucking line. And I'm good with that as long as I'm peaceful. As long as 7 years from now I'm taking my daughter to preschool. I really like that as well. Cherish these days, they go quick. Just yesterday, I thought it was 06, and you know, this being proposed to, all things go. We keep waiting for a moment to live, so can't nobody ever tell me that I'm wrong. I'm gonna ride with you till the night is still young. The second verse I wanted to highlight, I lost my cousin to a senseless act of violence. Because they killed my little cousin Nicholas, but my memory was only. Nicki family went through devastating tragedy in 2011. Her cousin was shot and killed in Brooklyn. Huh. And then this portion is very highlighted here, all the rest of the verse. Apparently, Nicki's cousin wanted to bunk with her in her house before he died. However, she just found out that her newfound fame is intimidating to her family. They're afraid to call. Huh. Okay. That's got to be weird, too, man. You try and make it. You got friends and family, and then you make it, and then it all gets weird with your friends and family, which is, that's not fun. Especially when, you know, you want to celebrate with those people and then all of a sudden the relationship is weird because of it. Anyway, let's keep going. This is a cool track. I've already got a heart next to it, so we're off to a great start. Let's keep rolling. We'll finish it up here.
Let me make this clear. I'm not difficult. I'm just about my business. I'm not into fake industry parties and fake agendas. Rock with people for how they make me feel, not what they give me. Even the ones that hurt me the most, I still show forgiveness. I love my mother more than life itself, and that's a fact. I'd give it all if somehow I could just rekindle that. She never understands why I'm so overprotective. The more I work, the more I feel like somehow they're neglected. I want Kaya to go to college just to say we did it.
All things cool. Great production too. It just does a great job of matching the tone of the lyrics. Like, they're pairing together really well. It's good sound. It's an enjoyable beat, but it's not over the top. Really cool track. I'm very surprised. Pleasantly surprised. That was good. All things go. I like that one. I like that one quite a bit. And mostly because it caught me off guard. I didn't expect something like that to be the opening track for The Pink Print by Nicki Minaj, you know? All right, let's go on to track two. It's called I Lied, produced by Scully and Mike Will Made It. All right, track two, I Lied. Schooly? Not Scully, probably Schooly. Good vocals.
You thought you was ready, and I said, let's see. But I ain't mean that. I need some fucking proof. Cause what happens if I fall in love, then you cut me loose? You just a heartbreaker. Won't let you break mine. Cause I'll be smashing windows and cutting the brake line.
I'm enjoying this track. It's actually connecting with me a little bit because I don't know how to say this without, like, I don't want to, like, dump out my childhood. I didn't have, like, a terrible childhood or anything like that. But there were some things that happened that made it such that I was isolated, I suppose, and became very independent pretty young in terms of just my personality and how I interacted with other people and stuff like that. And because of that, I've established, well, I don't know if established is the right word, but I do have a tendency to disconnect pretty quickly. I can cut ties. And I think it's a defense mechanism from stuff that happened when I was a kid. And I've never really done anything to sort that out. And typically it's not a problem, but every now and then I see it creeping up. And I don't know how to handle it. And what sucks even more is I see it happening and it just kind of happens. I don't like stop it, which bugs me. And so there's some friendships that have happened and just certain things that have happened in my life where I've just let it disconnect. And I think a lot of it comes from this idea. You know, obviously I think Nicki is focused more on a relationship with a person, you know, more of an intimate relationship, not like a friendship or maybe a family member or something like that. But this idea of before this becomes painful for me, I'm just going to clip it, you know? And yeah, it's kind of funny for me to be sitting here connecting with the Nicki Minaj song. never in my life did I think that would happen. And really for me, I think what's connecting, even though she's saying I lied, and I think it's really implied to the idea of, you know, I lied to that person to convince them to go away or whatever, so that, you know, the relationship. But then what I've experienced is I'm lying to myself in a sense, where I refuse to acknowledge this thing that's happening. And I just go, well, we'll see. And that's the lie. Because I know what's going to happen. When I say we'll see, what I'm really telling myself is I'm not going to do anything about it. And that's the problem. I hate to be vague about that, but you know, this goes up on the internet. People watch it. I don't know who watches it. Every now and then I get a text from somebody, oh, I watched your video. You did? Oh, shit. Oh, shit. I didn't realize. Okay. So anyway, there you go. But I'm just sharing that connection. And it's what I like too, is how my own personal thing can tie into a song like this, even though they're not directly related. You know, I still take this as like an intimate relationship type of song, even though that's not necessarily the case.
I thought eventually you would let me go. That was my insecurities and my ego. Missed my jump shot, missed my free throw. Missed the way we kissed, missed the T.O. I guess is what I gotta do to keep me from falling, stalling the truth. Who knew what you would do if I let you in? So I lie.
That was great. You take this track too and you pair it with track one, All Things Go. You know, you get this idea of things go so fast and it's over before you realize and all this other stuff. And then you've got this other idea of pushing away from a relationship. And, you know, for me, I am internally just laughing. I'm sitting here getting misty-eyed on track two of fucking Pink Print by Nicki Minaj. But my connection to it is this idea, okay, these past relationship things that I've let go, probably prematurely, right? And then life goes on and then it's over and yeah. Oh man, sitting here face to face with some of my own shit right now. It's really interesting, man. It's really interesting what music can do. Cool track. You know, it's early. There's still a lot of songs left. But that, I think for me, even though there's probably more tracks I'm going to enjoy more, I think that one's going to be a very personal favorite right there. I Lied, track two. That's a good one. Very. Now we're moving into the crying game. I didn't know it was going to be a fucking an emotional ride, you guys. I had no idea. This is great, though. This is really good. I want to go back. I haven't said much about the lyrics. You know, for the most part, it's straightforward. But there was a line in here that reminded me of another song. Oh, where was it? It was in the first verse somewhere. You said you was... Oh, this was great. You said you thought you was ready, and I said, let's see. And it reminded me of Fiona Apple. I can't remember the line off the top of my head right now. It's from the track Fast As You Can. You say you won't go. You say you don't spook easy. You won't go, but I know and I pray that you will. Oh, God, the way she sings it. I love Fiona Apple. You say you don't spook, you don't spook easy. You won't go, but I know and I pray that you will. Fast as you can, baby, run free yourself of it. Fast as you can. Great track. Go listen to Fast As You Can by Fiona Apple if you haven't heard it. Great track. Anyway, just that phrasing. You said you thought you was ready, and I said, let's see. Obviously, lyrically very different, but it just, my brain immediately went to that track because I've always loved that song. Very, very good song. Track three is called The Crying Game. It's produced by Pop and Oak, and it's featuring Jesse Ware. And that name is not familiar to me. Let's jump in. Track three, Crying Game.
Cool production. Laced with drugs. You ain't play your cards right. You had the ace of clubs. Hit you with the ace of spade in your face and shrugs. Blood dripping out.
I like that little guitar in the back. Rubs.
We was just planning a wedding, Caucasian doves. You was just telling your mans that you hate the clubs. Now we in the crying game, heart laced with slugs. When couldn't see.
Just say, oh, where did you go? I think Courtfield. Oh, this is so fucking catchy. So I just want to say two things. First of all, this is legit as fuck. Like, I can understand why people would not be into this. I get that. And we're early into the album. I know there's some huge fucking tracks coming up with several hundred million listens. So, I mean, this is early. But this is legit. Legit. So people who aren't going to give Nicki credit... I'm already not interested in that opinion. Second of all, I'm wondering if I can put this on for my wife, if my wife's gonna turn into a Barb, because I feel like she'll probably get into this. I don't know. We'll see. The only thing that would keep her hesitant is she tends to enjoy, you know, happier stuff, and this isn't quite happy. But you never know. You never know. Really enjoying the vocal performance. Nicki's great. Her voice is great so far in this album. You know, the cry, I haven't hammered into the lyrics like I normally do. It's pretty straightforward. This is annotated though. This is interesting. You know, here we go. The game, it's the game we love. Sheets all over the floor, and they're laced with drugs. That was really interesting to me. Nicki sarcastically says they love being here. They love being here because it happens a lot. Yeah. Substance abuse. Okay. You ain't played your cards right. You had the ace of clubs. I hit you with the ace of spades in your face and shreds. Blood dripping out of your arm on my Asian rugs. So was the guy strung out on heroin? He was planning a wedding, Caucasian dubs. You hate the club. So was the guy strung out on heroin? Nicki reportedly cut her ex-boyfriend Safari. Something she had referenced. Let me call back to you guys mentioned earlier. It's tripping. Not a lot of detail in the annotation there. Interesting though, that little description of what's going on. All right, let's keep going. Verse two.
Welcome to the crying game where you
that little guitar sound is great.
Ain't no easy cash, really. You gotta use the toll. Ain't no cruise control, you about to lose control. Ain't no smiling faces here, we slamming doors and dishes. Saying we don't miss each other, but it's all fictitious. Saying that we had enough, but enough of what? Another slap to the face, another uppercut. I'm just abusive by nature, not cause I hate ya.
Yeah, I fucking like this one too. This is 3 for 3 on hearts right now. This guitar build is fucking phenomenal. I love it. Especially with Jesse's voice. Fucking great. That was great. 3 for 3. I mean, these are all pretty chill jams too. I got merch coming real soon. I wore my Fire Jam shirt because I figured Nicki'd be spitting a bunch of fire. I didn't realize we'd be into like these chill jams, emotional jams, you know? This is crazy. That was great. It was really good. Really good. You know, you get into the second verse here, some of the stuff that Nicki said about, you know, how I'm abusive by nature, not because I hate you. So one thing I really appreciate about the relationship I have with my wife is that we're both pretty calm, easygoing people. There's not a lot of like chaos and getting worked up and yelling and all this other stuff. Like we get on each other's nerves and stuff, and we can get a little heated sometimes, but it's nothing crazy, you know, nothing, another slaps and uppercuts and all this other stuff that are in this line. Another slap to the face, another uppercut. This line was really interesting. I know it's hard. I know I intimidate you. That is really interesting. But is you staying or going? And I like that line a lot just because, you know, it kind of flips the script a little bit in terms of the relationship and who's in charge, because often guys like to think they're in charge, but then you create this dynamic of the guy being intimidated of the girl, and that can just be a total head fuck for some dudes. Especially if, you know, she's extremely successful and popular and all this other shit. Like, yeah, there are, unfortunately, there's a lot of guys that have a hard time with that. What would I do? I don't know. What would I do if my wife was incredibly successful and famous and millionaire? I'd probably be swimming right now in the pool with some champagne at 9 a.m. Have a good day at work, boo. All right. Let's move on to track 4. It's called Get On Your Knees, featuring Ariana Grande, who I don't think I've ever listened to before. Productions by Circuit and Dr. Luke. This one's got 80 million listens, so we're starting to get into some of the bigger tracks off of the album. A lot of the bangers that look like on the back end on the later on. Track 4, Get On Your Knees, and let's jump in. Check it out. Neat little production sound right there already.
Get on your knees, get on your knees, get on your knees. Baby, just get on your knees.
On your knees.
Say pretty, please, say pretty, please, say pretty, please.
Yo, I'll be back at 11. You just act like a peasant. I got a bow on my panties because my ass is a present. Yeah, it's good to the making. You look good when you begging. I'll be laughing when you begging me to just put the head in. Let me sit on your face. It's okay, you can play with it. When I'm bouncing, to chill out and don't you make a mistake with it. Let me see what you're working with. If I'm riding, I'm murking it. Slow grinding, I'm twerking it. Yeah, I bagged on my Birkin dick.
You got a bag for it, bag. I wanna see you looking up. Baby, I'ma need you to bed.
Wow.
Get on your knees, get on your knees, get on your knees.
So I'm gonna pause it real quick. This is what I was expecting, right? I was expecting an album full of this, which, you know, I know Nicki's got a persona, and she's kind of, you know, presented in a certain way, and I think this is, you know, probably what most people think of when they think of Nicki Minaj, stuff like this. But there's some great lines in this, especially right the previous track. This whole idea of the guy being intimidated by the girl, it just opens up. Yo, I'll be back at 11. You just act like a peasant. Like, the queen is leaving the king, the castle. You just stay here, peasant, and wait for me. And I love the next line too. Got a bow in my panties because my ass is a present. It's fucking brilliant. That's brilliant right there. Oh God. Okay, let's keep going. This is more what I was expecting here.
Assume the position. Make me way smarter like you's a magician. Pay my dues and tuition. It's good for your nutrition. Go ahead like a beautician. Got me twitching. Finish your mission. Finish your mission.
Oh my God.
Make it run down. I'ma need you to get these other dudes to run down. You got that legendary. This shit is fake scary. Got me staying a firework. I'm on my Kate Perry.
Baby, I'ma need you to bear.
I love how much the vocals swell right there. Holy shit.
Baby, it's primal. I want you on all fours.
I'm gonna pause real quick. I know I'm killing transition, but one thing that's cracking me up is how, like, Ariana Grande's doing a great job singing right there, right? Just phenomenal vocals, putting it all out there, whatever. And I'm having a hard time because I feel like they're taking the job, the lyrical, the singing seriously, very seriously. They're really putting in great effort. But then the lyrics, like, I don't know. It feels like it's so far beyond satire. We're back to reality again, if that makes any sense. It's just cracking me up. I'm enjoying this. It's very surprising to me too. They put so much swell, and then they let the track come all the way down. And I assume that that's kind of to maybe give an audio representation of somebody crawling, you know, slowly creeping up to them on their knees, because it swells so much and then it drops, and it does kind of give me this feeling of looking down at someone who's crawling up to beg. Very entertaining. I'm gonna put a heart next to that one. Yeah, we're 4 for 4. This is fucking great so far. Track 5 is called Feeling Myself. Oh my. Featuring Beyonce, produced by Beyonce and Hit-Boy. This one's got 340 million listens, so this is a bigger track. So is the next one, which is called Only, but we'll get to that later. Track 5, Feeling Myself. I imagine this is probably about, you know, like some sort of like deep emotional soul searching, you know, really feeling yourself and trying to understand where things are coming. It has to be, right? It can't be anything sexual at all.
Yo, B, they ready. Let's go.
I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling myself.
I'm with some hood girls looking back at it, and a good girl in my tax bracket. Got a black card and less sex habit. These Chanel bags is a bad habit. I do balls, down Mavericks. My Maybach, black matted. Bitch never left, but I'm back at it. And I'm feeling myself, Jack Rabbit. Feeling myself, back off. Cause I'm feeling myself, Jack off. Maybe think about me when he wax off. Wax on? National anthem, hats off. Then I curve that nigga like a bad horse. Let me get a number 2 with some Mac sauce. Or on a run tour with my mask off.
I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling myself.
Cool little beat.
I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my.
Change the game when that digital drop. Know where you was when that digital pop. I stopped the world. Male or female, it make no difference. I stopped the world. World stop.
Carry on.
Very fucking entertaining. Very entertaining. I want to go back to verse 1. I don't want to skip all lyrics, you know. I'm with some hood girls looking back at it. And a good girl in my tax bracket. Got a black card. Let's sax. That's probably Saks Fifth Avenue. I was thinking Goldman Sachs, but that's different. That's a bank. Saks is probably Saks Fifth Avenue. Chanel bags. I don't know. Doll Mavericks. Maybach is a car. But this, the first two lines, I'm with some hood girls looking back at it. Maybe that's just reflecting. I'm not going to read the annotation. I've changed my mind. But they're probably just, she's with her friends. They got all their fancy shit. They're just kind of reflecting back on where they came from, probably. Never left, but I'm back at it. I'm feeling myself, Jack Rabbit. I love this. I'm feeling myself, Jack off. He been thinking about me when he whacks off. National anthems, hats off. And I curve that guy like a bad toss. I was really happy. You know, I was worried. There was a feature. Beyonce was a feature on a track. I think it was a Kanye song. I don't remember which one now. And I was all excited because Beyonce was going to be a feature. And then it was basically just her singing the same like verse, the chorus or something. It was like really limited feature. And so I was hoping it was going to be more than just feeling myself. And then she drops in with this post chorus, which was great. Yeah. In verse 2, if I read verse 2, I'll probably start blushing tremendously. He said, damn, Nikki, it's tight. I say, yeah, you're right. Damn, babe, you're so little, but you really be taking that pipe. Yes, daddy, I do. Give me brain like NYU. Phenomenal. Phenomenal work. Let's keep going.
Whipping that work. You digging that work. I got it. 36 of that real. Thank you, full of that bounce, baby. Come get you some of that bounce, baby. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling myself.
There's something cool about this beat, man. Myself. Like,
I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my.
He in love with that cook. Why these bitches don't ever be learning? You bitches will never get what I be earning. I'm still getting plaques from my records. That's urban. Ain't gotta rely on top 40. I am a rap legend. Just go ask the kings of rap. Who is the queen and things of that nature? Look at my finger. That is a glacier. Hits like a laser.
I love her rolling
R's. You like it, don't you? Young Money.
So that verse was very entertaining, and it was cool because initially she started real slow, and I was like, this is interesting because it starts, you know, bitches ain't got punchlines or flow. I have both in an empire also, but she was saying it very slowly, and I was like, huh, okay. But then obviously drops into some self-awareness by then tearing through a good portion of verse 3. Especially when she got into this, you know, ain't got to rely on top 40. I'm a rap legend. Just goes to ask the kings of rap, who is the queen and things of that. And then crosses the bar line. nature. Look at my finger. That is a glacier. Hits like a laser. Fucking great. That's pretty good. I like the idea of a diamond being so big that it's a glacier, and so much light reflecting off of it is like a laser. That's pretty good. Pretty good. That was cool. We're 5 for 5. I'm enjoying myself quite a bit. Quite a bit. There was something else I was going to say, and I forgot. I forgot. Damn it. Oh, there was the thing about Texas. They kept talking about riding through Texas, and the annotation was talking about, I guess Beyonce is from Texas, and I didn't know that. Anyway. Okay, cool. Fun. Very fun. Next track is called Only. It's featuring Lil Wayne, Drake, and Chris Brown. Is this before Chris Brown beat the shit out of Rihanna? I don't know. Or after? I don't know. That was a while ago. I mean, this is from 2014. I feel like all that stuff happened even well before that. That was a while ago. Anyway, Circuit, J Mike, and Dr. Luke is the production crew on this one. Let's drop in track six is Only.
Yo, I never fucked Wayne, I never fucked Drake. All my life, man, fuck's sake. If I did, I'd menage with him and let him eat my ass like a cupcake. My man fool, he just ate. I don't duck nobody but tape. Yeah, that was a setup for a punchline on duct tape.
Yep.
Worry about my butt fake. Worry about y'all niggas are straight. These girls are my sons, John and Kate. Plus 8, when I walk in, sit up straight.
Good base.
I don't give a fuck if I was late. Let it soak in like seasoning. And tell them bitches blow me. Lance Stevens.
Freeze every bottle and cup in the sky.
I think this is the first time I've ever heard Chris Brown. Ever.
Nothing but bad bitches in here tonight. Oh, if you lame and you know it, be quiet. Nothing but real niggas only. Bad bitches only. Rich niggas only. Independent bitches only. Boss niggas only. Thick bitches only. I got my real niggas here by my side.
I remember what I wanted to say on the previous track, that final verse on Feeling Myself, where Nicki gets going, because she's got all these like hesitations and there's a couple voice changes and stuff like that. After having seen Kendrick Lamar live and seeing what they do live in terms of some of these ad-libs and the vocal stuff that they do, I can appreciate that verse a lot more because I can imagine it live and how much she plays with it live. So it's probably a lot of fun, some of the stuff that she was doing on the back end of Feeling Myself. That's a strange sentence right there. Anyway, if there's a cool live performance of that track, I'd like to see it. Put a comment, please, so I can check it out. Because I'd like to hear her do that verse live and see how she plays with it live setting. What's going on with this opening line here? I never fucked Wayne or Drake. I assume this was a rumor. Disavowing the notion she ever slept away to level of success. She's been addressing these kinds of rumors since 2009. The pink print overall has a strong thing of Nicki using her sexuality on her own terms. Okay. So I guess there was rumors. Who knows? Anyway, the fucking line. If I did, I'd menage with them and let them eat my ass like a cupcake. That was fucking funny. I do have to say, though, then she drops into the next part. You know, I don't duck nobody but tape. Yeah, that was a setup for a punchline on duct tape. Okay. I wasn't into that one at all. I mean, I understand what she's doing, but yeah. Okay. That was kind of a home run and then a strikeout immediately after, in my opinion. Let's hear what Drake says. Let's see if my inner Drake-hating demon that I have yet to confront. I got to do a Drake album soon to confront this demon. Let's see if I can enjoy this or what he's going to say.
I never fucked Nicki cause she got a man. But when that's over, then I'm first in line. And the other day in her Maybach, I thought, goddamn, this is the perfect time. We had just come from that video. You know, LA traffic had a city slow. She was sitting down on that big butt, but I was still staring at the titties, though. Yeah, low key and maybe high key. I been peeped that you like me, you know? Who the fuck you really wanna be with besides me? I mean, it doesn't take much for us to do this shit quietly, I mean. She say I'm obsessed with thick women, and I agree. Yeah. That's right, I like my girls BBW. Yeah. Type don't wanna suck you dry and then eat some lunch with you. Yeah, so thick that everybody else in the room is so uncomfortable. Ass on Houston, Texas, but the face look just like Claire Huxtable. Yeah, you the man in the city when the mayor fuck with you. The NBA players fuck with you. The badass bitches doing makeup and hair fuck with you.
I enjoyed that verse. That was a good verse. I liked it. That was good. Here we go, Lil Wayne.
I never fucked Nick and that's fucked up. If I did fuck, she'd be fucked up. Whoever is hitting ain't hitting it right. She act like she need dick in her life. That's another story. I'm no storyteller. I piss greatness like gold is yellow. All my goons so overzealous. I'm from Holly Grove, the holy Mecca. Talent to say I got running for days. I sperm and I shake, but I'm stuck in my ways. My girlfriend would beat a bitch up if she waved. They better not fuck with her surfboard. Surfboard, my eyes just so bright, I take cover for shade. Don't have my money, take mothers instead. You got the hiccups, you swallow the truth. Then I make you bird boy. Creepy flex, Sirloin, I'm talking about running in houses with army guns. So think about your son and daughter rooms. Got two hoes with me, messed up, they got smaller guns. Ain't thinking about your son and daughter rooms. This shit is crazy, man.
Bad bitches only. Rich niggas only, independent bitches only, boss niggas only, thick bitches only. I got my real niggas here by my side. Only.
You know, initially when the track was first going, because this has got 450 million listens, so huge track, right? I think this is the biggest one off the album. Yeah, biggest one off the album. Initially, I was like, huh, I'm not really into it that much, you know, because the production wasn't doing a whole lot. You know, it's cool. It's a cool beat, but okay. And then we started getting into some of these verses, and I was like, oh, shit. These are some really good verses. You know, even Chris Brown just essentially doing the chorus. It's a cool little chorus, too. So then I started to realize, okay, the verses are doing a lot of the work. And then I started to realize, well, it's not necessarily that the verses are doing so much work and the production isn't that great. I think the production is taking a step back so we can really enjoy the verse. So kind of like there's always the debate in rock about, you know, what makes a good drummer, and people think you got to go diddle 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 all the time. But if it's a mellow jam, you don't fucking diddle diddle diddle. You know, you tap, 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 you know. So it's cool to kind of see that all play out and develop and realize, yeah, the fucking verses are pretty good. And so the production's taking a step back so we can really enjoy that. I'm really interested in Lil Wayne's verses, because we get down to the back end here. What was it? Where was it? So think about your son and daughter rooms. Got two hoes with me masked up. They got smaller guns. Ain't thinking about your son and daughter rooms. What is going on here? Good luck with Beef of the Way, and he'll serve you just like a fine dish. Okay. Weezy made a whole song dedicated to his army guns back in 06. I need to listen to some Wayne. I haven't done any. I will start with the Carter 1. I'm going to start there. This was it. Blood Gang, take the B off behavior. What is that? He's affiliated with the Bloods. Like all gangs, are notorious for their violent behavior. Oh, blood without the B is lewd. Lewd behavior. Okay, that makes sense. I didn't understand it. I was taking the B off the actual word behavior, and I was like, e-havior? What? I don't get it. I like that little, the little part. The pop, pop, pop. That was cool. Yeah, that was fucking cool, man. I'm putting a little heart next to that one. We're 6 for 6 so far. Pink Print is doing its job quite well. Quite well. Track 7 is called Want Some More. Produced by Nicki, Metro Boomin, and two more. And Metro Boomin, let's see, Zaytoven, and I don't like this, and Hitmaker. Metro Boomin was the guy, he does 21 Savage. If Metro don't trust you, I'm going to shoot you. That's the tag, right? Right? Is that right? I think so. What was that I did? Without Warning? I think that was Metro. I don't know. We'll see. If I hear the producer tag, I'll know. All right, let's jump in. Track 7. Want Some More, and we'll continue what so far has been a fantastic experience with Nicki Minaj. That's a hit.
I'm in this bitch, I'm getting money. One minute they hate me, then they love me. Ain't got nothing for me, these dudes is funny. That's why I'm throwing shade like it's sunny. Who had Eminem on the first album? Who had Kanye saying she a problem? Who the fuck came in the game, made her own column? Who made Lil Wayne give him 5 million? Why the fuck I gotta say though? You niggas don't know it yet. Football touchdown on a Boeing jet. You my son, but I'm just not showing yet. Miss Icy, but it ain't snowing yet. You could tell I'm the illest, cause my dividends is the biggest. Bitches ain't sitting with us, all my niggas in Margiela's. Is pigs flying? Is these bitches trying me? They think it's sweet. All these bitches got diabetes. You seen that list? It was me, baby, Jay-Z, and Diddy.
You know what's really cool is, as we were coming into this, I was kind of thinking, you know, one of the things I wanted to hear as I explore this album was how well does she actually rap, you know? And so the first couple tracks caught me off guard because I was expecting something that was not serious, and those were pretty serious. And, you know, hadn't really gotten into a whole lot of rapping really from Nicki. Feeling myself, that final verse, she tore off a little bit. Here she's finally breaking out a little bit, which is perfect because I was just starting to wonder, what's this thing? You've seen that list. It was me, baby, Jay-Z, and Diddy. What's the annotation here? The Hip Hop Cash Kings 2013 list is a huge testament to Nicki's success. She was placed as the number 4 top earner with 29 million, making her the first female rapper on the list. Wow. That's pretty fucking impressive right there. On top of Kanye, on top of Lil Wayne, on top of Ludacris. Huh. Interesting. There's some great lines in here too. Where was it? Where was it? His pig's flying is these bitches trying me. They think it's so sweet. Oh, they've got diabetes. I like that verse. And, you know, she finally kind of tears off with some flow, which is good. I was waiting to hear some of that. All right, let's keep going here.
I'm in this bitch. I'm Hasta Diddy. I popped a perk and I said thank you. I'm popping tags every day, it look like my B-Day. These bitches suck, so I nickname these bitches BJ. They want that union, they want that D-Way. I tell them, ho, just be happy, they getting leeway. Even though a nigga been getting to it, want some more.
Still want some more.
Want some more. Want some more. Every time I end up getting it, want some more. When they start talking crazy, that's when I know that they
want some more.
There's a line here, you people apologize when a person or an individual disses you, that's a big problem. And so you get to the annotation, it talks about apologizing in rap beef is a huge taboo. This could be a reference to Ransom, a rapper Minaj had previously collaborated with during her days on the come up. In 2013, Ransom dissed Minaj by claiming he'd written her verses early in her career. When she fired back, he immediately apologized. Interesting. What's up, kitty? You want outside? Yeah. Okay, I guess we're taking a quick break to let the kitty outside. Okay. Kitty is outside and temporarily happy. what was I going to look at? I can't remember now. The D-Wade. That was, he's a basketball player, right? I'm not going to click that. There was something else. I get it. I don't want to be wanting for nothing. I mean, I do what I do, and it must be counting for something. I don't be jumping from topic to topic. Stay in my pocket. I got your rent in my pocket. So can I pay you to pop it? Cash Money, getting 6 albums, no bitch individuals on a bitch album. What is that reference to? That's the one I was talking. She's at the top and doesn't want any whack rappers on her albums. Obviously, sure. This could possibly be a subliminal diss towards label mate. Yeah. Okay. Or it's probably just straightforward. I'm enjoying this. Yeah. I'm going to put, let's see. I'm not going to put heart next to that one. I've been putting heart next to everything. We'll let that one wait. Let's move on to track 8, which is called Four Door Aventador. I don't know what that is. That's got to be like a type of car or something, right? I assume. Produced by Parker, last name there. There's a last name as well. track 8, Four Door Aventador. I don't know. Let's see. Yeah, gotta be a car.
Penny, come on for you, boy. Being a funky four door, no floor.
Hit me on the celly.
watching Belly. Godson, I could see they study Machiavelli. Peanut butter pins, got them jelly at the deli.
Machiavelli, if you feeling like Tupac, a ninja, right?
I got a machete. Hell yeah, them girls bad, but they're fucking heavy. I'ma fuck around and have them looking like spaghetti. I say some shit, he be like, yo, you so legendary. But he could tell just by my face he ain't getting any.
Penny, more for your boy, me in the funky four door. No floor, he was setting that roll. Oh boy, she was making that noise. Oh boy.
But they money in they whips, putting kitten on lips. Dividing them dividends, get the money and dip. Keys to the nigga safe, put it under my tits. He got keys of that roar, it could fit in the six. Got the UPS connect, so we good on them trips. Automatic bottle service, so we good in them vips.
Now this one only has 23 million listens, which is by far the least off of the album. I'm not really into it. I imagine most people skip this one. Excuse me, that's gross. I should have muted the mic whilst burping, but anyway, I'm just gonna let it play out. We'll see if there's anything interesting that pops up, but yeah, I'm not really into this one.
These civilians, what up nigga, excuse my millions. I'm in the V like a widow's peak. It's just me and my Rolls Royce pillow seats. I'm getting acting money. You niggas is Kevin Hart, y'all be acting funny. I'ma keep a linebacker, tell him tackle for me. Yo, you seen my last pick, go double tap that for me. Cop back, red octagon, stop that.
Yo, that track's tough because I feel like I enjoy the production. I mean, I feel like it's weird how every now and then it seems like all of these elements are in play and they're functioning, but it just doesn't land, you know? It's strange. And then there's the inverse, right? Where it's all this chaos, like JPEG Mafia, and it works, even though your brain is like, there's no way this should work, but it works. So it's just strange how that works out. Four-door, whatever. Yeah, wasn't really into that. I mean, it looks like that's not a hot take by any means based off of the plays there on Spotify. We'll move on to track 9, which is called Favorite, featuring Jeremy. I don't know. Produced by Rob Holiday, Nicki Minaj, and DJ Camper. Track 9, Favorite.
Oh, no drama. I just want to be a diamond, babe. Guaranteed to be a problem. Every time I get around you, babe, I just want you to need me. You might really wanna try me, babe. All I know I wanna ride up. All I know I wanna ride up, babe. You know that you need a rider. You know that you need a rider, babe.
A nice spacey production kind of sound right here.
Yo, I just wanna be a writer. You should pull up in that spider. You should let me hit the mic. And I ain't talking about the fighter.
That's it right there.
Let's pull an all-nighter. Tell me what you need. Got the weed, I'm a bad little bitch. And I'll never indict her. Get locked, I'ma write ya.
Interesting.
You wanna roll, I'ma Skype ya. I don't wanna hype ya, but you a lucky nigga if my mean ass like ya. You ain't never have a bitch understand you. Most of them wanna use you when they ran through. I just wanna be somebody that can add to your wife, be a friend, be a teacher, and a fan too.
It's really interesting how the production, it was like building and getting that like really crunchy sound, and then it went away and got like all subdued and spacey, and then it came back to the crunchy sound. Really, really interesting.
Let me update your status. Cause it's you I would change for. You always make sure.
I just wanna be your favorite. I just wanna be your favorite.
I like this part of the beat right here. Quite a bit.
I just wanna be your favorite.
It's weird how it pulls back though.
I just wanna be your favorite.
I don't know how I feel about that one. I'm not gonna put a heart next to it. I'm curious to see if that grows on me over time. It's pretty experimental in terms of just what they're doing with the production, how they bring that sound up and it's real crunchy and it's there and it's kind of hitting and then it pulls way back again. It's really kind of interesting. And I feel like this track is probably pretty divisive in the sense that you're either totally into it or you're not into it. I feel like there's not a lot of people who'd be like, yeah, it's fine. I feel like you're either gonna enjoy it or not really be into it at all. There's some cool lines in here. Let's go back. I didn't really touch on the lyrics too much to begin with here. Where was it? I don't want to hype you, but you're a lucky person if my mean ass likes you. I like that one quite a bit. You may never have a bitch understand you. Most of them want to use you when they ran through. I just want to be somebody can add to your wife, be a friend, be a teacher, and a fan too. I mean, that's kind of a cool line. I like that. I just want to listen. When you leave, I don't want to say, damn, I fucking miss him. You know, it's kind of neat. Was there something in verse 2? Meet me out. This was what was interesting to me. Meet me out in Queens where the city want a sundown. You could put your gun down. You could have fun now. You could tell your friends that you won now. One down. Run through the clubs with the baddest, bitches is the maddest. Nothing else matters. So that was kind of interesting to me. Just this idea of, I guess that's her way of saying, you know, you can settle down. You can relax. You don't have to be so wild anymore. You don't have to be living out on the edge. It's kind of interesting. That's cool. I'm curious. We'll see if that one grows on me or not. We'll see what happens. Let's move on to track 10, which is called By a Heart. It's featuring Meek Mill. That name is familiar to me. I'm pretty sure I've heard a Meek Mill feature before. I want to say off of a Kanye track, but man, I can't remember. I've been going through a lot of music. It is hard to remember these days. Produced by Hitmaker and Arch the Boss. Here we go. Track 10, By a Heart.
Anybody wanna buy a heart? Anybody wanna buy a heart? Anybody wanna buy a heart? Cause I don't use the shit anyway, but okay, I guess it's my fault. Whoa, West Side Jordan. With an East Side nigga. They say there's levels to this. I'm a G5 nigga. In that city I be in. You know she fly with us. It's like Hov got B. It's like B got Jigga. Really though, let me take y'all back. 09, double R, drop top with the top down. Pulled up, double park, hot out, try split my game, it ain't work, got shot down. But I can tell by the bag, by the wrist and the ring on that. Somebody had it on lockdown. And moral of the story, not to speak on that. She on the team, should he mind now. Anybody? Anybody?
Anybody, anybody, anybody wanna buy?
Nice hit on the chorus here.
Anybody,
cool,
anybody,
cool chorus. I'll pause it here. I like that chorus. Very catchy. This threw me off, though. I like this. You know, tried to spit my game. It didn't work. Got shot down. I can tell by the bag, the wrist, and the ring on it. Somebody had it on lockdown. The moral of the story, not to speak on that. She on the team now. Shorty mine now. And we don't ever, ever, ever make love. And we don't ever, ever, ever say love. Unless I'm all up in it. She's telling me she loved that D on that. I don't ever say, bad bitch. So that threw me off. But now after reading through it again, you know, then he talks about anybody want to buy a heart because I'm not using mine. Maybe she's cheating on her man or whatever with him. That's why I got to assume that right there. Right? He noticed how she had a ring and a finger indicating she could be married. If it wasn't ready, the quality of her exes, they got together afterwards. Huh. Okay. Yeah, so I was on there. All right. According to the annotation, I'm on the right track. Catchy chorus. Let's hear Nikki's verse here.
Rameek, I'ma have to tell the truth if I speak. Unless you wanna play, you ain't say this the other day. You said you was in love. And I still didn't budge. Cause I already seen how you be going in when you be in them clubs.
I could tell you was analyzing me. I could tell you was criticizing me.
I like the subdued sound here.
He could tell I was wifey material. He was liking my style and my videos. I wasn't looking for love, I was looking for a buzz. So at times I would lie and say I'm busy out.
Cause it's too much, and it's too clutch. Who wants rumors of the two of us? But when you're away, I
her voice is so good right there. I mean, I know there's some layering going on a little bit, but there's a little bit of an effect. Not much. Huh. Cool little closing section right here. I feel like the end of this track, I could listen to another 90 seconds or so of just kind of some cool outro beat, but I'm sure it was probably designed like, oh, we're hoping this can get played in the club or something like that. Although, you know, it's funny because clubs, they clip the end of songs all the time. All the time. So, I don't know. I kind of wanted a little bit more there at the end. Because this outro, it's a heart for sale. Who's buying? I don't care who's crying. It's trust for sale. Who's buying? I don't care who's lying. It's a really interesting outro there. And then if you're left with those lines on just a real kind of contemplative type beat, or you can just kind of soak in that for a little bit of while. You know, a little bit of while. What does that even mean? A little bit of while. Thanks, brain, for making me look dumb. I'm gonna have to tell the truth if I speak, unless you want to play, you ain't say this the other day. You said you was in love, and I still didn't budge, because I already seen how you be going in when you be in them clubs. I could tell you was analyzing me. I could tell you was criticizing me. I could tell you was fantasizing that you would come and slide in me and confide in me. He could tell that I was wifey material. He was liking my style, my videos. I wasn't looking for love. I was looking for a buzz. So sometimes I would lie and say I'm busy. Too much, too clutch, rumors. Interesting song. I like this one. I did put a heart next to Buy a Heart. Oh, yeah. A little bit of a, not quite a pun, but getting close, dangerously close to pun territory there. Interesting song. Interesting beat. Very good production on the chorus, especially. They're really just kind of hammering on that one. They're trying to make that really catchy. Based off the listens, that one didn't really blow up, but that's okay. Cool track. Let's move on to track 11, which is called Trini Dim Girls. Featuring Lunch Money Lewis. That name is not familiar to me. Produced by Alexander Castillo, Circuit, Dr. Luke, and J. Mike. All right, let's jump in. Track 11, Trini Dim Girls.
Brixton girls, them my pack the pum pum, them my wine up them waist, them my pack the pum pum. Queens them girls, them my pack the pum pum, them my wine up them waist, them my pack the pum pum. Trinity them girls, them my pack the pum pum, them my wine up them waist, them my pack the pum pum. Jamaican girls, them my pack the pum pum, them my wine up them waist, them my pack the pum pum.
Yo, he in love with a ghetto girl. He said he want a piece like Meadow World. Pat pat on a kitty cat. He don't mess with them regulars. He tryna kick it like a ninja. He tryna stick it like syringes. He don't ever play the benches, so I'ma let him touch it. They be playing with some hinges. I know that you want it. I see that you watching. You love when I whine it.
I feel like this was another attempt to make just another fucking club banger, right? I mean, it just has that aesthetic, that feel of just banging this shit in the club. I want to click on the chorus annotation because this is, I feel like this is Jamaican in a sense, but I don't really understand what he's saying in terms of what it's supposed to mean. Nicki Minaj was raised in Queens, New York. It wasn't what she expected as a 5-year-old. Okay. Oh, okay. Well, let's hear what the quote is from Nicki. A lot of times when you're from the islands, so I guess she's from Jamaica. A lot of times when you're from the islands, your parents leave and send for you because it's easier when they have established themselves, when they have a place to stay, they have a job. I thought it was going to be for a few days. It turned into 2 years without my mother. Wow. When I went to New York, I thought it was going to be like a castle, like white picket fence, like a fairy tale. I got off the plane and it was cold. I remember the smell. I could always remember the smell when I got out of the airport. Of the snow. Oh, the smell of the snow. Okay, sure. and I'd never seen snow. All right, being from Jamaica, I remember the house. I remember that the furniture wasn't put down. I was like piled up on each other, and I didn't understand why. Interesting. Interesting. There was something in here. What was it? Maybe not. He trying to stick it like syringes. He don't even play the benches. So I'm gonna let him touch it if he's playing with some inches. I understand the reference. He's trying to stick it like syringes. Maybe that's just it. I'm trying to find like a deeper level there, but it's probably not it. Like he's a junkie just trying to stick it in, right? Let's keep going. Interesting song so far.
Put it in his face like a cop badge. He wanna punt it like a hashtag. He gonna have to get the wash rag. If he shoot it up, I'ma bust back. Them island girls is the baddest. American girls run the planet. South African, European, Asian, Australian, and my Canadian girl. I know that you want it.
Super catchy right here.
Watching. You love when I whine it. You know that I'm sexy. I hope that you're ready to come here and get it. With the ad girl, them. He want a bad girl to come and spend his money. He say it tastes good. Just like honey. In love with a girl from the islands and not a miniskirt flow. I know that you
cool shift here.
I see that you watching. You love when I whine it.
Jamaican girls in my pot, they pump them, then my wine up them waist, then my pot, they pump them.
So that track, was a kind of a challenge for me because very, I don't want to say poppy, very clubby, however you would categorize that. And I'm sitting here listening to it. I'm enjoying the production. Nice quality, rich sounds coming out. You know, the chorus, Nikki's vocals are just nice and I don't want to say angelic, but just good, good, good sound, right? Nice and rich. And the whole time, my 42-year-old brain... This may come as a shock to some of you, but I'm not a prominent figure in the club scene. I gave up that lifestyle so long ago. Right? So I'm enjoying the song. I'm part of me is enjoying the song. And the other part of me is it's not even 10 o'clock yet. And I already want to go home. And there's too many people in here. And my feet kind of hurt. And no, I don't want to pay $14 for a Red Bull vodka. And my fucking head is pounding. And someone... just said something to me. I have no idea what they said because it's too loud in here. And I don't fucking care what they said because it looks like she's talking to me, but she's not talking to me, but she's on her phone. She wants me to connect her friend. I don't know. I don't know. Sorry, I can't hear you. Sorry. No, I'm sorry. I can't hear you. No, I'm just. That's old brain right there. And I'm not even that old. But when it comes to the club scene, at least in my opinion and the friends that I have, once you hit like 30, you're like, fuck the clubs, man. It's just no. So that one's a challenge because I like what's happening with the sound. I like what Nikki's doing with her voice too. I kind of like it when she threw in the Jamaican accent a little bit there. That was neat. But it was hard for me to vibe with it. You know, it was almost like I was having a PTSD moment. Fucking, oh no, I'm an old man in the club. Oh no. All right, track 12 is called Anaconda. This is the one I've been looking forward to the most. Oh, saucy picture there. I believe this song is about anaconda, which from what I understand is a very large, girthy, heavy snake, right? It's difficult to handle because it's so big and heavy. And yeah. I'm excited. Let's drop in. It's produced by The Interns, Anonymous, and Polo to Don. Track 11, or track 12, I'm sorry, is Anaconda, another big song, almost 390 million listens. Let's check it
my
out.
Anaconda don't. Oh, my Anaconda
Sir
don't.
Makes a lot.
My Anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hun.
Boy, toy named Troy, used to live in Detroit.
I may have heard this before. I think I've heard this before.
Was the shootouts with the Lord, but he lived in a palace. Both bought me Alexander McQueen. He was keeping me stylish. Now that's real, real, real.
Gonna Sir Mix-a-Lot samples great.
That's the kill. By the way, what he say? He can tell I ain't missing no meals. Come through and fuck him in my automobile. Let him eat it with his grills. He keep telling me to chill. He keep telling me it's real that he love my sex appeal. He said he don't like I'm bony. He wants something he can grab. So I pull up in a jag and I hit him with a jab like dun 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 dun.
My anaconda don't. My anaconda don't.
This dude named Michael used to ride motorcycles. Dick bigger than a tower. I ain't talking about Eiffels. Real country ass nigga, let me play with his rifle. Pussy put his ass to sleep. Now we calling me NyQuil. Now that bang, bang, bang. I let him hit it cause he slang cocaine. He twist my salad like his name, Romain. And when we done, I make
this next portion, right, this post-chorus, the oh my gosh, look at her butt. My wife and I recently did a, because I don't think my wife had ever seen the music video for I Like Big Butts, or what's it called? Baby Got Back, I'm sorry, Baby Got Back. And so we did a video, I think it's just on Patreon, of watching that video. And it was so funny to watch, because it's that's from the 80s, and it's that girl, oh my God, look at her butt, it's so big. And my wife and I were both like, It's not even big. Like, holy shit. Like, things have changed. Things have changed, man. This is fucking very entertaining. Little in the middle, but you got much back. Little in the middle, but you got much back. Little in the middle, but you got much back.
Oh my God. Look at
my
her
anaconda back. Don't. My anaconda don't. My anaconda don't want none. You got buns, hun.
Oh my God.
This one is for my bitches with a fat ass in the fucking club. I said, with my fat ass big bitches in the club. Fuck the skinny bitches. Fuck the skinny bitches. Come on.
That, you know, I was just talking about, you know, the PTSD of being in the club, right? If that song would have came on, all right, I can at least take a break from complaining about everything around me to enjoy this song for a little while. I had not heard that before. That was the first time I heard that. I was kind of disappointed with the chorus in the sense, like, I like it on one hand because it's a cool, not parody, it's a cool nod to Baby Got Back, and then, you know, Sir Mix-a-Lot kind of changing the chorus and doing his own thing instead of Big Butts and, you know, Anaconda and all this other shit. I like that. But there's really no, like, actual chorus to it in a sense, you know? So I was a little slightly disappointed there. He can tell I ain't missing no meals. Come through and fuck him in my automobile. Let him eat it with his grills. And he telling me to chill. He's telling me that it's real, that he loves my sex appeal. He say he don't like him bony. He wants something he can grab. And in the end, it's just hilarious. You know, fuck all these skinny bitches. it's funny. Very funny. You know, honestly, looking at the song title, I was expecting it to be a lot more, what would be the word, salacious, I suppose, raunchy, what have you. And it's kind of funny, like I was saying in the beginning, kind of coming face to face with the misconceptions of preconceived ideas I have about Nicki Minaj, all from media representation, or should I say misrepresentation, right? Because I've had this idea of Nicki just being super, super raunchy and all this other shit. And I mean, there's been some lines in here, sure. But overall, nothing outrageous. And the parallel that immediately comes to mind for me is all the things I had heard about the glorification of gun violence and drug dealing and all this other shit, right? That idea that I used to have in my mind and how that was not accurate either. So it's really interesting to go through even the song Anaconda and be like, that's really not that bad, honestly, in terms of, you know, bad being over sexualization or whatever you want to call it. Entertaining. Putting a heart next to Anaconda. I like that one. Jesus. All right, let's keep going. This one's called The Night Is Young. This is track 13, produced by Circuit and Dr. Luke. And we shall drop in. Oh, The Night Is Still Young. Not young, still young. Catchy little opener here.
Ayo, tonight is the night that I'ma get twisted. Mix Moscato and vodka, I'ma mix it. Roll that spaceship, we about to get lifted. Live in the present, that gift is for the gifted. This what you came, this what you came for. You get what you buy, this what you pay for. So make sure the stars is what you aim for. Make mistakes though. I never worry.
Oh my god. Fucking bass line. Little guitar lick in there. Jesus Christ. Oh my god.
Drinks on you or the drinks is on me. We ain't going nowhere like tanks is on E. We still getting money, what think it's gonna be. If he's sexy, he planking on me. So when them big boys with all of that, tell the bartender say my order bet. It's bottle service, he ordered that. Might let him take it home and slow the debt. We brush the death down to the shoes. My only motto in life is don't lose.
God, this part is so fucking catchy. Oh my god. Oh my god. Just gonna pause right here. I feel like the pre-chorus is catchier than the chorus. Got the bass line, that little guitar lick. The chorus almost slows down compared to the pre-chorus. I wanna go up. There's a line that's annotated, and sometimes these are fucking hilarious, okay? You know, tell the bartender, say my order back, it's bottle service, he ordered that. Might let him take it home and slaughter that. We all know what that means, right? Let's click the annotation and see what it says. Here we go. This will be great. Slaughtering someone means having sex with them. If she decides to go home with him, she'll let him hit it once they get to his crib. Oh my god. The idea of picking girls up from bars and nightclubs has been around forever. Jesus. Oh my god. Like, there's two contributors to this annotation right here. I don't even know fucking, like, it just reeks of like Reddit, doesn't it? Oh, that was great. I'm glad I clicked on that. Well, let's click on this one. This might be entertaining too. We ain't going nowhere like tanks is on E, right? Right. We're not going anywhere. We got no gas, right? Tanks on empty. Oh, it's just a picture of a gas tank. When the tank is empty, the car isn't moving. This could also be a double entendre, meaning they are on ecstasy. If you leave the club on E, you will probably get caught because of your eyes. Oh, okay. Okay. Oh, my God. It's like club songs for toddlers, right? It's just amazing. Amazing. All right, let's keep going. It's just... very entertaining. Some of these annotations, man, they just crack me up. We're just getting started, yeah, yeah. Cool little subdued section started, here. Yeah, yeah. Can't you see the night still early? And we gon' get it wild and crazy. Oh, it's building. Started, yeah, yeah. It's building. You know, that song right there, Anaconda, what was the other one? There's been some others. Shit, I can't remember. Anyway, I'm coming to the conclusion that I think my wife is going to enjoy this album, which is going to be fucking amazing because her whole family is like Christian conservative and stuff. And they're not over the top about it, ridiculous about it. They're reasonable people. But I can't wait to like have a conversation at Christmas and basically try and weave it in that my wife enjoys listening to Nicki Minaj. Because the facial expressions are just like, what? How? What? Who? That one girl? Yeah. Anyway, super catchy. Another thing I was thinking about too, I'm glad I'm doing this album right after Thriller. Right after Thriller. Thriller was obviously just production. I mean, Michael Jackson's a great singer too. Don't get me wrong. I'm not trying to like overlook him by any means. Amazing what he did. But lots of production. And I feel the same kind of experience with this album so far. There's been a lot of focus on production. You can tell they're really trying to put these little hooks and sounds and catchy things and all the shit to just make it just honey on the ears, right? And so far it's been really fucking good. And I know I haven't said a lot about the lyrics. For the most part, it's all been pretty straightforward. So there's not been a lot to like, you know, kind of sift through and pull from. The first couple tracks really surprised me in terms of just the experience, the little connection that I had there. The annotation for might let him take it home and slaughter that. Oh, God. I love the internet sometimes. Most of the time I hate it, but I love the internet sometimes. All right, that was cool. Heart next to that track. So what's neat with the back end of this album, we got Anaconda with almost 400 million, Night Is Young, 250, Pills and Posters, 200, Bed of Lies, 150, Grand Piano, 100. So it's like the back end of this album is kind of a banger, which is cool because the middle for me slows down a little bit. So maybe this album suffers a little bit from bloat overall. You know, maybe they're just trying to get a lot of shit in there. And there's some tracks I remember thinking they're trying to make this one like hit, but it didn't really hit. But I'm glad it's going to wrap up with some strength. So let's move on to track 14, which is called Pills and Potions, produced by Circuit and Dr. Luke. Here we go, track 14. Interesting beat.
Pills and potions.
Oh, wow. I didn't expect this.
They're overdosing. I'm angry, but I still love you. Pills and potions. We're overdosing. Can't stand it, but I still love you.
Another catchy song.
Hey yo, they could never make me hate you. Even though what you was doing wasn't tasteful. Even though you out here looking so ungrateful. I'ma keep it moving, be classy and graceful. I told them it's no friends in the game, you ain't learned that yet. All the bridges you came over, don't burn that yet. Niggas want respect, but niggas ain't earned that yet. Self-righteous and entitled, but they swearing on the Bible that they love you. Ooh. And really they no different from all your rivals. Good. But I still don't wish death on them, I just reflect on them.
Good line right there. I want to go up a little bit here. This is a cool verse. People want respect, but people ain't earned that yet. Self-righteous and entitled, but they're swearing on the Bible that they love you when really they're no different from all your rivals. I still don't wish death on them. I just reflect on them. I'm going to click the annotation. Bit of lies. You know, the thing with the Bible is you swear on a Bible when you're in court. So that part's interesting because it makes me think of divorce court, you know? I've never really heard anybody say, you know, I've heard people say, I swear my life or I swear on whoever, right? But not on the Bible. You swear on the Bible when you're in court. That to me is very specific. Huh. Swearing on the Bible that they love you when really they're no different from all your rivals. I'm going to keep moving. Be classy and graceful. I told them it's no friends in the game. You ain't learned that yet. All the bridges you came over, don't burn that yet. Cool line right there too. Yeah, this is cool. And again, just super fucking catchy chorus. Let's check out verse 2.
Yo, people will love you and support you when it's beneficial. I'ma forgive, I won't forget, but I'ma dead the issue. Soon as you out of niggas' lives, it's when they start to miss you. They see you doing good, now it's kinda hard to diss you. Niggas be sick when they remember all the bad they wished you. Niggas be mad when they can't come and live lavish with you. But I sped off in the Benzie. I see the envy when I'm causing a frenzy. So I pop pills for 'em. Cop cribs in the hills on 'em.
Pills and potions, we're overdosing. I'm angry, but I still love you.
So I want to talk about one line real quick before I forget all of the track end. You're going through, you know, as soon as you're out of their lives, they start to miss you. They see you doing good. Now it's hard to diss you. And you get further down. They get mad when you can't be mad when they can't come and live lavish with you. But I speed off in the Benzie. I see the envy when I'm causing a frenzy. So I pop pills for them. And the track's called Pills and Potions. That line right there, so I pop pills for them, is really interesting to me. And then you drop into the chorus, pills and potions, we're overdosing. And so the only reason why I focus on that is because we're overdosing. Pills and potions, we're overdosing. And right before that, she's talking about popping pills for them in response to how people are acting. You know, they're envious and they're mad at her and all this other stuff. So she's overdosing from these experiences continually happening. That's what I get from that. And I mean, I don't think that's necessarily hard to, you know, pull out of this track. But just the idea that these things, right, as soon as you're gone, that's when they start to miss you. And when you're doing good, then it's hard to diss you. And, you know, people be sick when they remember all the bad they wished you. They're mad when they can't come and live lavish with you. Just all of these, I don't know if you want to call them toxic relationships or whatever, the envy, the anger, the all that stuff. It's happening so often that, you know, every time it happens, she pops a pill for him and she's overdosing on pills and potions. Kind of interesting. Kind of interesting. People love you and support you when it's beneficial. I'm going to forgive. I won't forget. But I'm going to dead the issue. I like that. Interesting track. And it just sucks how often this comes up. So often, JPEG Mafia was tweeting some shit the other day, which I love pretty much everything he tweets. That guy, that guy tweets some wild shit. But you just hear this all the time. Like, people don't want to help you. They don't want to do anything for you. They won't give you the time of day until you make it. And then all of a sudden, they all want your attention. And it's like, it's just bullshit. It's total bullshit. And I can see why it makes people so upset, because I'd feel the same way. Like, what the fuck, you know? All right, let's finish up the track. I've done a lot of talking.
I get high off your memory.
That's a good line too. I get high off your memory.
Off your memory.
Not you, but remembering.
I get high off your memory. In due time, it'll be fine.
Yeah, that's cool, man. I'm really enjoying this. There's a lot more depth here than I was led to believe, you know? And it kind of pisses me off, honestly. Like, I'm sitting here, I'm enjoying the music, the album, everything about it. The middle slows down a little bit. We got two more tracks. I shouldn't get too hung up on like a closing thoughts thing, but it's just in my head right now, like what my perception of Nicki was 2 hours ago compared to right now. All right, let's keep going. The next track is called Bed of Lies, featuring Skylar Gray. I don't know who that is. Produced by Today, Alex the Kid, Bray and Isaac, J. Mike, and Kane Beats. Track 15, Bed of Lies.
Pretend you would be
Good vocals here. Great vocals.
Lie down in your bed of lies.
You could never make eye contact. Everything you got was based off of my contacts. You a fraud, but I'ma remain icon stat. Balenciaga's on my boots with a python strap. You was caught up in the rush and you was caught up in the thrill of it. You was with me way before I hit the quarter mil in it. Put you in the crib and you ain't never pay your bill in it. I was killing it, now you got me popping pills in it. But there was something that I should've asked all along. I'ma ask on the song.
Do you ever think of me when you lie?
I am gonna pause. Well, let's go through one more verse from Nicki and then we'll look at lyrics here.
I just figured if you saw me, if you looked in my eyes, you remember our connection and be freed from the lies. I just figured I was something that you couldn't replace, but there was just a blank stare and I couldn't relate. I just couldn't understand and I couldn't defend what we had, what we shared, and I couldn't pretend. When the tears rolled down, it's like you ain't even noticed them. If you had a heart, I was hoping that you would show us some.
This is a cool track. I really like the chorus. Skylar Gray is doing a fantastic job. Do you ever think of me when you lie? Lie down in your bed of lies. And a new better look in your eyes. This is what really catches me. How you made me believe you had me caught in every web that you weaved. That's an interesting, the wording there is very specific. Because when I read it, I think how you tricked me into the webs. But that's not what's being said. How you made me believe that you had me caught. And so more so the idea is the lie. How can I articulate this? Because it's right on the tip of my tongue, but my brain is not helping me at all. It's just making me look dumb instead. I guess the first thing that comes to mind is like gaslighting. Like, no, it's, there's so many lies that the person like Nicki or whoever has been tricked into thinking, oh, maybe he's not lying, you know, maybe not. Like, oh, because that's really what that means. That you can only believe that you've been caught in the web if the web is essentially just smothering you. But do you ever think of me when you lie? Do you ever think of me when you lie? Do you ever make eye contact? He was caught up in the rush. So it sounds like a relationship, you know, she was in. While she was coming up, you know, it was with me way before I hit a quarter mil in it. You know, put you in a crib, you never had to pay a bill in it. Now I'm killing it. You got me popping pills in it. He's bugging. I was doing it for us. I told him, fuck the public. Couldn't believe I was home alone contemplating overdosing. And I like the pre-chorus too, you know. Don't know what you got till it's gone. Darkest hour before the dawn. Sometimes I'm going to ask all along. I'll just ask in the song. Do you ever think of me when you lie? You know, it's strange to me too how there's going back, what was the very first track? That line in there about how he's intimidated of her, or I know I intimidate you, or something like that. It's also really strange to me to just picture anybody who is with somebody like Nicki or whatever and see them succeed and come up and grow and, you know, money and fame and all this other stuff, and then start to treat them like garbage. Yeah, that's weird, right? Isn't it supposed to be the other way? Like, I don't know. Like, I mean, this sounds awful. This is just as awful, but like they're not famous and they don't have a lot of money, then it's like, well, who cares, right? But I just feel like if you're that type of person, you're going to try and take advantage of somebody, you would work harder at it when, you know, they're a meal ticket. And maybe that's what this is about. Maybe that's what the lies are. Maybe this other person is doing all the shit and then just lying to try and keep hold of the meal ticket that has become Nicki Minaj. Maybe that's it. Huh. Maybe my brain's not so dumb after all. It takes me a while. It takes me a while to get there sometimes. Figured if you saw me, if you looked in my eyes, you'd remember our connection and be freed from the lies. Figured it was something that you could replace. Blank stare and I couldn't relate. what we had, what we shared, and I couldn't pretend when the tears rolled down. It's like, you ain't even noticed them. If you had a heart, I was hoping you would show it some. Huh. Really interesting. All right, let's keep going.
You know I've been in that bed before. A thousand count and not a single thread of truth.
Thousand count, not a single thread of truth. That's amazing.
If I was just another girl, and I knew better than to look in your eyes, they only pretend you would be mine.
Nice hit right there. Nice hit right there. Huh. Cool track. Oh, it just ends really fast, though. That was great. This line right here. So does she know I've been in that bed before? A thousand count and not a single thread of truth. So the sheets, you know, you thread count. A thousand count, not a single thread of truth. That's a great line right there. And then I like the next part too. If I was just another girl, you know, if I was just another girl, then I'm ashamed to say that I'm not over you. Yeah. Good shit. That's a good track, man. Fucking A, dude. This is so surprising. I figured it'd just be smut. Filthy, filthy, awful smut all the time. No, this is a phenomenal album so far, man. I mean, well, let's do the last track and then I'm kind of slipping into additional thoughts or closing thoughts here. Last track is called Grand Piano, produced by Nicki Minaj, the mad violinist. How mad, though? How mad? Today, Keith Harris, Will.i.am. Will.i.am is familiar. And Kane Beats. Final track, track 16, Grand Piano. Cool. I had no idea Nicki Minaj could sing. I had no idea.
Am I just a silly girl? Now the people are talking. The people are saying that you have been playing my heart like a grand piano.
Ooh, good line, good line. I'm surprised by the post-chorus here. You know, this idea of people are talking, he's playing you like a grand piano. And then she says, so play on. Play on, play on, play on. Yeah, it's really interesting. Kind of surprised, honestly. Am I just a fool, blind and stupid? This is beautiful. I'm really curious to see where this goes. I should shut up and listen to it, huh? Instead of talking. Very cool. Wow. Wow. That was amazing. Let's go through this. If somebody would have just played that song for me, no context, no nothing, right? And just said, who is this? Never. I would have never guessed Nicki Minaj ever. I would have started guessing. Wow, very, very surprising, very impressive. Where was it? this pre-chorus, the one who came to take claim of his heart, cold-hearted, shame you'll remain just a frame in the dark. That's the line that's really sticking to me right now. Everything else is pretty easy to understand, but that I'm not quite getting, and it's no annotation. Cold-hearted, shame you'll remain just a frame in the dark. So the only thing I'm kind of getting from that is this idea of, you know, there's been lots of kind of this throughout the album, struggles through relationships and, you know, splitting apart and Bed of Lies and what was the other one, The Crying Game, and you know, some stuff like that, right? I Lied, where she's cutting off. The only thing I can think of is this song is kind of like a reflective, maybe thinking back to the relationship that has ended, that like it's over. And so even though there's this theme of play me like a grand piano and the people are talking and all this other stuff, this is probably wrong, but I feel like it's more of a, the relationship has ended, years have gone by, but she still loves him type of a thing. And so that idea of play on, play on, play on, it's just whatever's going on, there's still these feelings deep down inside. And maybe, you know, this whole, well, I guess I could click the annotation here, but I don't want to. I'm just going to run with this idea. You know, the people are talking, the people are saying that you have been playing my heart like a grand piano. That makes it sound very present. But I wonder if it's more so an idea of this person, whoever it is, every now and then says something or does something in the public that's kind of a swipe at Nikki. And maybe it just stirs up these feelings, but way deep down, there's just still love there. And so the whole idea of it just keeps going, just play on. I don't know. Fuck, man. Wow. Bed of Lies, grand piano. Huh. Wow. This is a trip. This is just a total trip, man. And I was saying a little bit earlier, I'm kind of frustrated because I feel like there's so many people out there who hear the name Nicki Minaj, they immediately get an image in their head. They think of a couple crazy songs that are salacious, obviously over the top, ridiculous tracks, and they have no idea this exists. No idea. Huh. Interesting. And so it makes me wonder, the people who are, you know, haters on Nicki or try and discredit what she does or her place in hip hop or her ability to make music or whatever, it makes me wonder if they've ever taken the time to fucking listen, to listen to her albums. I mean, this is one album. I think from what I understand, this is her more popular album. This is a great album. It slows down in the middle. You know, it starts out for me, I've got a bunch of hearts, and then it gets a little gappy. And then from Anaconda down, a bunch of hearts. So I feel like maybe this album could have been trimmed. Instead of 16 tracks at an hour, it could have been like 12 tracks at 50 minutes or 45 minutes, and it would have just been a fucking crusher of an album, you know? But when you get that little lull in the middle, you know, sometimes that hurts it. But whatever. I'm curious to see how some of those other tracks grow on me, if they do. Huh. Wow. I'm so glad I did this. I had no idea. And honestly, I remember thinking when I was deciding, okay, I'm going to do Nicki finally. And I had heard some stuff about her fan base and how they can be like, you know, like rabid and really intense or whatever. Right. Like I was like, oh shit. You know, I hope I enjoy it. I hope I don't stir things up with, you know, the intense fan base. But now I feel like I understand why there's such an intense fan base, because I feel like just off of my first fucking listen, off of one album from her, I feel like she's so misunderstood. Or maybe not necessarily misunderstood, but misrepresented. Like the media in general only shows like this part of Nicki when there's this huge range that exists. Huh. Oh man, I can't wait. I'm really excited to play this for my wife and see what she thinks and see if she gets into Nicki. I kind of think that she will. I don't know. We'll see. Because she likes the singing. She likes the upbeat. There's a lot of production, you know, and some of them are just fun, silly songs that she can get into a little bit. We'll see. I'm very curious. Huh. Pink Print. Nicki Minaj. That was fucking great. That was great. It was great. I really enjoyed it. Yeah. Wow. Huh. I mean, I don't want to act too surprised, but I am surprised. Yeah. Okay. Cool. We'll see you guys.